Okay, quick review. Everyone bet on the Saints to win. Andrew and Dave both locked the Saints to win. And Kevin guessed the start of the game, and for that I give him bonus 3 points. So let's look how it looks this week.
Wow.
Bring the wife on the show. Get the boy on.
Kevin, we're just lapping the field is disturbing.
Yes.
Like, I feel like something happened, Dave, when Kevin was like, hey, if you move the show and we do it on, I'll move my schedule around and I'll be back on the show full time now. I feel like when that happened and the draft channel in Discord happened and Kevin became like a fucking football savant and like all his takes are solid. He's got legitimate good predictions. It's very disconcerting. And I have to say, I don't really like it.
You know who's the smartest one?
Yeah. All right, wait, hold on. Okay, so we're at zero. Well, hold on. My son just got home from the Pelicans game. He wants to say hello.
My son.
He looked. He got your wife's good looks, Dave.
He did get my wife's good looks. We lost.
Hello there, fellow kids.
Yeah, Kevin's got a skateboard, so he can talk to you.
I can talk to the youth.
He can talk to the youth. Hello. All right, good night. Love you.
How about that Lizzo, huh?
Lizzo.
And that Bruno Mars.
How about that?
Let's see who that in the chat.
Oh, I forgot.
Is that even your kid, Dave?
Fatherly affection there from Dave Cariello.
Damn.
Look at that.
Dude, the Saints are getting it together and the Pelicans are falling apart.
Is that even your kid?
Mexi Hudad from the top rope. Jeez.
It's an actor that I paid. He's already, he already got in his Uber. And
Dave looks concerned, guys.
He does.
You may be up to something, Mexi.
So 18 points for Kevin. Okay, this is.
So before we get to the pick.
This is ridiculous.
I think Juwan Johnson. That's right. Kevin deserves to be out front, and it's just very disturbing to me. But Tiger Saint says, rent a kid.
Yeah.
But before we get to the pick,
the kennel.
Before we get to the pick, I think we need to acknowledge and remind the people the weather in Cleveland on Christmas Eve, high of 12 degrees, 35 mile an hour winds. And a 50% chance of snow. This game has the chance to be an unwatchable, straight back to the 70s kind of game. Just so when you make your picks, boys, the weather is going to be a fact.
I look forward to hearing you say 67 to 10.
I did. I had to change my score when I found out the weather report today. I'm not going to lie.
You did minus points for that.
Tiger Saint says shenanigans run amok. You are not kidding.
All right, so Tomas, you want to give us Andrew's pick since he's not here?
Well, no.
I think we can go with Andrew last.
Andrew sent a video.
Okay, great. All right, I'm in favor of that.
Pristine quality, guys.
So I'll go first, Kevin.
Sure.
I was going to say 31-17 Cleveland, but then I saw the weather report and I had to change that all around. I forgot that Kevin Thomas put it up there. I even forgot my score. I think it was
change it and forgot it, man.
I did change it. 9-6 Cleveland. And I don't even remember who was my turn of the game.
Jesus.
I forgot. I mean, listen, man. You know, I got a lot going on. Here's the thing. The Saints have cycled through number two running backs. Eno Benjamin fumbling in the cold in Cleveland and costing the Saints this game. I feel like it's preordained by God. So Eno Benjamin is my turn of the game.
Now, wait a minute. Didn't I have 0 points last week?
No, you had minus five.
You had minus five, man. Get on the program.
What I was that was up from what?
Trying like to
minus
keep up.
10? Was that up from minus 10?
It was minus 9 2 weeks ago.
Oh my gosh. Juge, all right.
Man, Juge had minus 4, so I gave you all more right. points than Juge
no,
for the same
no,
thing,
yeah,
basically.
Oh, no. Thank you.
You should
Father.
Be thanking me, yeah.
Yes, no, thank you, Father, for I have sinned. Thank you. you want me to go?
Yeah, go ahead.
All right, I'll go. I said earlier, Dennis Allen won last week. Mathematically, he's out of the running.
He's capable of winning two in a row.
He's out of the mathematically. He's out of the running for this week. So it would be stupid for any of us to pick the Saints to win. I'm thinking, you know, just for schlitz and giggles. I think this is going to be a blowout. This is going to be an embarrassment for Mickey.
Oh my God.
Deshaun Watson is going to have a game.
Oh,
no. We're all going to, all the idiot Saints fans are going to be like, oh, see, we should have signed Deshaun Watson.
Oh, like no.
Hi, I'm Masseuse.
Yeah. So I'm saying Browns 35.
That is f***ing stupid.
Saints. What did I pick the Saints to have? I don't even remember. They're losing. 10. Yeah, that's not right.
You go to Rafi here for a second.
Oh, yeah. No,
hey,
it's gonna be
the over under in
that.
This game.
No, no.
The
this
total
is
32.
I know that. Well, I know that. I know that. And I bet the over. Yes. This is going to be Deshaun Watson's like coming out party, like re coming out party. Where everybody's finally like, oh, this is why the Browns took a chance on him. So Mickey Loomis, poo of the game for not signing Deshaun Watson. We could have Deshaun Watson, incredible quarterback.
But if we had Deshaun Watson, we wouldn't have him on the show.
Just roll with it. No. Just, I know.
The chat says, right, the Saints 17-10. A lot of people in the chats are picking the Saints 13-10. Hatchet John says 17-9.
Everyone's picking
Jerry
the Saints
17-10. Rashid Shaheed, star of the game. The Browns are the worst run defense in the NFL. Even Tampa ran the ball.
That means the Saints actually have to run the ball.
The Saints ran for 130 against Atlanta.
Okay, but that means we're going to have to get Kamara on the field. Okay.
Fair enough. Well, Taysom could run the ball. They could run the single wing in the bad weather.
All right. Well, hear me out, though. Run the veer. Give me the veer.
Yes.
I want the veer in a professional football game. Okay. So you two jamokes decided to go with the Browns. Ralph, you're wearing an orange shirt, for God's
sake. I know,
sake.
I am. It's Astros orange,
you
not
absolute
Browns. No, that's pretty
fraud.
Much Browns. That looks like pretty much Browns.
Absolute clown frauds here. You got all the fans here in the chat picking the Saints somehow through some sort of way, some sort of shenanigans. And am I not a man of the people?
You are a man.
Am I not a man? Am I not the voice of the voiceless, as it were?
You are.
The two of you who actually get
the voice
that.
Of the teenagers.
You.
Voice of Hello. The teenagers. Kevin.
Hello,
and
everyone.
The ladies.
It's your Uncle Kevin here.
Your Uncle Kevin here.
Making predictions.
Remember, predictions here.
You got a gambling Saints. Problem.
Call 1-800.
Got a pick here for you. Saints, 17. Browns, 14.
Ooh.
Star of the game. Pew, pew, pew. Pistol Pete Werner.
Ooh.
I got to like say. That. I'm a little more confident in this game now that Kevin's picked the Saints. Like,
hang on a minute.
I mean,
hang on. Tomas.
Oh, Jesus. He's
lock that shit in.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
This is his lock of the week of
the century.
Lock of the
week of the century.
Of the year.
When was the last time the Saints, Kevin, before we get to Andrew's pick, I know the Saints played the famous snow game in Buffalo. In 89 with 4K. When was the last time the Saints played in horrifically bad weather?
Seattle last season, I think.
No, it wasn't. It would rain, but it wasn't like terrible.
Eagles playoff game. What was that?
That was pretty.
No,
cool.
I could have sworn that wasn't.
2006, they played in the Giants, but it wasn't snowing, but it was like 40 mile an hour winds or some shit, and Eli didn't cross midfield.
I was at that game.
But like, Maybe somebody in the chat, like, when was the last time the Saints played in horrifically bad weather? It's been a long time.
I mean, horrifically, like again, like when they played the Eagles and won with the field goal.
It was cold, but it wasn't like snowing, and it wasn't like...
It wasn't snowing during the game, but I mean, you know, there was enough snow to throw snowballs at the bus.
Ooh, they played in that monsoon in 2013 in Carolina. Yeah, 2017. No, it was 20. It was either 2017 or 20. I think it was 2013, Butteridge, because Cam Newton drove him down and won at the end. And it, like, the Saints were winning, and then they had a monsoon, and no one scored until it cleared up, and Cam drove him down at the end. Yeah. Jason Champagne says Saints 3, Browns 2. Star of the day is Jack Frost. Will it into existence, Jason? I am here for that kind of abomination on Christmas Eve. I'm here for it.
Field goal and a safety.
That's right.
Give it to me.
The Browns are horrifically bad on special teams. Like LSU 2022, bad on special teams. It's kind of been like herpes for the Browns. It's not. It hadn't flared up lately, but you know it's due. You know it's there, and it could happen at any moment.
You haven't been taking your Gardasil prescription or whatever the herpes is.
Thank you, Vicarious 28. Subscribe.
Hold on, it's a shot. Thank you. It's a one-time shot.
I don't know. Okay, what is Thomas, Gardasil? I just made that up.
I'm too old to get that, and I know what that is.
No, Thomas. What is it? I don't know what.
It's a shot. They give it to the kids, so they're safe when they get older.
Oh, for what? They're safe from what?
The herpes.
Hello, kids. As you get older and you start fooling around with one another, you may catch the clap. You don't want that.
Ask your uncle who fought in Vietnam.
Consult your pediatrician about Gardasil. Surprise your parents by asking about it the next time you're at the doctor's office. Just out of the blue.
Wait, no, I just made up. I mean, I know Gardasil's a real drug, but I just came up with it out of thin blue air, not knowing that it has any. What is it? Did I just guess correctly?
Yeah. It's the HPV vaccine.
Kevin.
Oh, really? Wow. Okay.
Kevin's PSAs for teenagers is my new favorite.
It's my new favorite thing, too.
Than Irish, Kevin. It really is.
Yeah, no. And it's easy because he just has to get the skateboard. He doesn't have to go into the accent.
So Thomas, play this Andrew video. He wasn't nice enough to grace us with his presence tonight. He had too busy beating old ladies in Baton Rouge at tennis.
He was too wasted on Vu Clicquot. He sent us a text message from the game. $27 for a glass of Vu Clicquot. Don't mind if I do.
Yeah.
He's so was the exact phrasing, which I think fucking qualifies him as the all-time champion.
He broke the bougie meter.
I think the bougiometer is busted, and it's going to be a couple of weeks before we can get somebody out here to take a look at it and maybe get it back up and running. Because when you say $27 for a Vu Clicquot, don't mind if I do.
It's like... Yeah, but your hand gestures when you say that belies something there, Dave. I see your hand motions.
Well, I'm I'm doing the hand motions that I'm assuming Andrew is doing as he's texting us.
Assuming.
Bouge.
You're still bougie, Dave. Don't try and hide it.
Don't mind if I'm pulling up that text. I'm going to show it to you all. I'm not lying.
Thomas, get to this Andrew video.
Yeah, play the video while Dave.
He's apparently very proud of it. He's texting me about it all day.
Mind if I do.
Jesus.
Yeah.
I don't think he should.
Oh, he's proud of
this
video.
What's up, guys? I'm sorry to miss the show, but I am wearing my
Zoom in
cat hat. An embarrassment and shame for missing it. So sorry to not be there, but I want to give you a prediction for this weekend. World Cup prediction, World Cup theme in light of Argentina just winning. 17 degrees outside. I feel like there's going to be a ton of missed field goals, ton of turnovers. I'm going to go with a tie. My prediction is a tie. Saints 6, Browns 6,
shut up.
And I don't know whether to pick a star of the game or a turd of the game, but I'll just say it's like penalty kicks and Will Lutz and Cade York both miss a bunch. Who dat?
Dude, how would a tie?
What is the hat? Can we?
What would it? What would that do to the playoff scenario?
Too late.
The hat looked like a cat. It. No, it's not too late. You can pull it up and you know it,
dude.
And it was like a cat face. Like, was that his daughter? Like, what's going on?
Something to do with
that hat.
What are we doing, Andrew? Come on,
look like his case hat.
That hat is the that is the Stanley Jean Baptiste of hats.
Jesus,
that's the Kevin Casehorn of hats.
That hat is.
That hat has seen some shit.
It looks like maybe his daughter made it, so I don't know. Maybe we like shouldn't be making fun of it.
It's a cat hat. It's like they said, I want a cat hat, but I want it to be military chic, and it needs to have sequins.
Yeah, enhanced. There we go. All right. Like, well, I'll say this. Cullen, I know you're listening. Your sister made an adorable hat. Great,
Corporal.
Good job. Cullen, if you made that hat, dude, sick hat, bro. Sick.
Dude, I want to call him General Buttons. Like he's
that's just, the General Buford Buttons.
General Buford Buttons. It's
that's the hat of a man who just watched France lose the World Cup.
It's a mouse.
It's a mouse?
Trucker hat, and it's bedazzled.
So yeah, just for the listeners,
you need to join us on the live stream.
The audio
only version. You have no idea what we're talking about. You missed the dazzled trucker hat.
Yeah,
the mice tried to surround us over at Little Round Top.
All right,
but I was fortunate enough to lead my platoon into successful battle.
Okay, look, here's how.
Now please give me a wand with some string on the end of it,
Kevin, I just want to let you know the way microphones work. If you get closer to the microphone, you don't have to be that
major,
loud.
Mittens.
You can tone it down. You really need to be watching on YouTube.
You really need to. You need to join us on the live stream.
A gray trucker hat, and it's got whiskers and googly eyes on it, and then on the back it looks like there's some sparkle silver ears.
It looks like something my wife would pay top dollar for.
Thanks for watching the Saints Happy Hour. Subscribe to our YouTube channel, then find us wherever you get your podcast, and finally go to saintshappyhour.com and become a patron of the best Saints podcast on earth.